to Moses and Jesus because he knew that the Jewish people held Moses in high esteem. For this one, it says, Jesus has been counted worthy of more glory than Moses. Next to Abraham, Moses was the most reverent man to the Jewish people. And when the writer wrote this book, this chapter 3, the Hebrew Christians were experiencing terrible persecution from the Jewish contemporaries. They were tempted to give up their Christian commitment and to go back to Moses and the law. The writer is trying here to convince them that Jesus is greater than Moses. The entire Jewish religion system came from Moses, but we know that grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Therefore, the writer encourages the saints, and he also encourages us today to consider Jesus Christ, to fix our thoughts on him. The author uses different pictures to express or explain Jesus' relationship with believers. He is the messenger of God to whom we should listen. He is our high priest through whom we come to know the Father. And he is the ruler of God's house whom we should obey. And if we go to verse 18 of chapter 2, it tells us that for in that he himself hath suffered being tempted, he is able to succor to aid. He comes alongside them that are tempted. And so it is in verse 6 that the writer continues to give encouragement. And if we look at the word verse 6 in chapter 6, we would see words like hold fast, confidence, hope, rejoicing. And hope, when a life is hurt and dreams fail, nothing counts like hope. Without hope, prisoners of war languish and die. Without hope, students get discouraged and drop out of school. Without hope, athletic teams slump and they keep losing games. Without hope, addicts return to their habits. Marriage couples decide to divorce. Inventors and artists lose their creativity. So that's why the writer is asking us to hold on to that confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ. So when we hold on him, we have hope. Without hope, even preachers and some strong Christians struggle to press on. But thank God, we have a better hope according to this chapter in Hebrews. There is no hopeless situation once we know the Lord Jesus Christ and hold on to him. There are only people who have grown hopeless about situations in their life. So this is why the writer is saying, have your confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ because he is your hope. But hold fast, my friends, there's a song that goes like this, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Life is worth living just because he lives. And to me, that is hope. In verse 6, we can also find the word courage, like I mentioned before. For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit discipline, a strong mind. We can stand up to the wiles of the enemy when we are courageous. I remember he said to Joshua to be courageous and be strong, because the battle was not his, it was the Lord's. And that same word of encouragement, encourage, comes to us as well in times of trials and struggles. The next word we find in verse 6 is confidence. And Hebrews 3:14 tells us, we have come to share in Christ. If we hold firmly till the end the confidence we had at first. So we need to be as enthusiastic about Christ now as we were when we first met him. So Christian friends, what I want to say to us today is to hold fast and hold fast to Jesus. There are lots of things we could put our confidence, we could put our hope in, but the one thing that stands forever is Jesus. And as we continue in this chapter, we see that the word states that Moses was faithful in all God's house as a servant. Jesus was faithful as a son. We do not look up to a servant, but we look to the son. Why? Because the son went to the cross and he died for our sin. The servant did not. So our focus should be on Jesus, our Redeemer, our friend, our Lord. He is the only one who can fix the circumstances in our lives and give us the joy that passeth all understanding. We're in the midst of a world that is about to end. I don't know if anybody thinks that, but I certainly do. And I know Rev think that too, because we talk about it. We are tempted on every side, facing only temptations, but many trials, and a great variety of things that make it hard for us to stand firm in the faith that we have our confession in. But what God says, saints and sinners, I am with you always. I will never leave you. I will never forsake you. I will be there to always hold you up. I will be there to give you strength. I will be there when you need to be steadfast and unmovable, when you need to be abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as we know that our labor is not in vain in the Lord, 1 Corinthians 15:58, and that's a sound promise. What the writer is saying is that before the resurrection of Jesus Christ, nothing we do or nothing that happened or nothing that is to come is useless. We should not let disappointment over any apparent lack or any results keep us from doing the work of the Lord. We should do it enthusiastically. As we have opportunity, the word says, we do good and we do the word of the Lord as he has blessed us. So in order to do that, we need to keep our focus on the Lord. Then there's the promise of God in Philippians 1:6. There God's promise is, I have begun a good work in you, and I will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. That's a promise. And God does not go back on his word. God says, I have begun a work in you. You didn't begin it. I did it. And having begun it, I am going to continue that work. I'm not going to start it and then let it rest. But this is my work, he's saying. I'm going to continue that work. And I'm going to continue it until the day of Christ. That is, until the day that Christ returns to take us as his work. He says, I will continue it. And I will finish it. I will perfect that work and complete what I have begun. And then God makes a promise. When he says, I will, he will. So all we need to do today, my friends, is to keep our focus on the Lord Jesus Christ. I read this little portion in a devotional I was doing, and it says, hold fast for that beautiful land in view. Hold fast for the crown that's awaiting you. Hold fast for the meeting of loved ones there. Hold fast for the bliss they have gone to share. Because we know that we are going to heaven, we can look forward to better things in every area of our life if we keep our focus in Jesus. It is through our most trying moments that we focus to see the light, and that light is Jesus.